Hey everybody! So this week, Danganronpa Another episode, Ultra Despair Girls, was released exclusively on the PlayStation Vita, and I'm here to tell you whether or not it's worth your money. Here are my thoughts.
Taking place after the events of the first game, the story follows Komaru Naegi, the younger sister of series protagonist Makoto Naegi, escaping her imprisonment after spending a year and a half locked away from the rest of society. After her escape, she realizes that she's in a mysterious, technologically advanced city where a group of children calling themselves the Warriors of Hope have made it their mission to kill all of the adults to create a paradise where only children are left alive. Using their army of Monokuma robots and children soldiers at their disposal, they've decimated the city, leaving bodies strewn about every which way. Komaru is captured by the Warriors of Hope after trying to escape, and is thrust into a game, where she must try to find a way to survive against insurmountable odds. Once she's let go, she meets Toko Fukawa, a character from the first game, and now armed with a hacking megaphone capable of destroying the Monokuma robots, the two work together to try and find a means to escape. The Danganronpa series has always had a knack for crafting stories that blend various tones and thematic elements together to create a compelling narrative, and another episode is certainly no different. For every silly, fourth-wall-breaking joke or over-the-top scenario, there is a dark and malicious undercurrent that always seems to keep you on your toes. Just when you get comfortable with the status quo, the game throws a truly unnerving or unsettling twist that really begins to eat away at you once you start to think about how things are. Watching children brutally murder adults and celebrate over their mutilated corpse is never something that's easy to witness, and even with the moments of levity thrown in, you always feel a sense of unease as you move into the next area. As you progress, the sense of dread never leaves the back of your mind, and even the goofy nature of the entire setup never really takes away from the overall message of how truly terrible it all is. I think a big portion of that is thanks in part to the deep and wonderfully crafted characters the writers have created. Komaru is not some badass hero character that wakes up one day ready to save the world. She's a reluctant hero throughout, and even when she begins to find her footing, the game reminds you of how fragile and insecure she can be. It's easy in a game of this nature for a character to suddenly snap into hero mode, but that's never the case here. She's a young teenage girl who's witnessing the greatest tragedy of her life and has been suddenly thrust into something that she never quite understands. At times, it can get frustrating at her inability to grasp the situation or her constant naivety, but in a sense, it comes off as more realistic than someone who just decides that she's okay with everything going on around her. Her chemistry with Toko is brilliant, and the friendship that these two develop throughout the course of this game is nothing short of astounding. Even the villains are rich and multi-layered characters, despite initially coming off as nothing more than a series of tropes. The same can't be said for most of the supporting cast, as many are just there to advance the plot or act as a means to inevitable end, but overall, it's an absolutely wonderful story that kept me invested throughout the entire 20-hour runtime. Unlike the first two games, which acted as a hybrid of visual novels and courtroom dramas, Another episode is a third-person shooter. While that departure from the series norm might come off as a bit jarring at first, it actually works really well, for the most part. The hacking megaphone that Komaru uses throughout the game is a wonderful device, with a ton of different ways to take down your enemies. You unlock various bullets the longer you play the game, each with widely different effects, and combining the different bullets together to take down a group of enemies is definitely a satisfying experience. There's a layer of strategy to how and when to use the different bullets, which become especially clear during some of the more puzzle-like segments of the game. If you become overwhelmed by the amount of enemies swarming you at any given time, you can switch over to Toko, who becomes an invincible killing machine capable of destroying any and everything in her path. Her time is limited, though, at least on the normal difficulty, and having her leftover power is the only thing that can save you from a possible game over screen, so figuring out if and when to use her becomes essential for finding a way to survive. The main issue with the gameplay is one that many third-person shooters suffer from. Repetition. While there are a number of enemy types thrown at you the longer you play, most of the time you'll be fighting the same set of enemies over and over ad nauseam. When you add in the fact that the majority of enemies take the run-at-you-head-on approach to battle, it ends up being more of a shooting gallery and less of a challenge, even on the highest difficulty. More often than not, the greatest challenge will be finding ways to collect more ammo and not anything that actually tries to attack you. Even the boss fights, which bookend the chapters, end up being nothing more than a shoot the red or blinking area until it stops moving fight. Outside of the puzzles, there is a real lack of strategy to the entire thing, especially when you consider the fact that you have a press triangle to win option at any given time with Toko. The camera can definitely be an issue as well, either on manual or automatic, sometimes getting caught on the wrong thing at the wrong time, but it worked for the most part and never really felt that broken. From a visual standpoint, the game is really something unique. Utilizing 3D rendered graphics alongside anime cutscenes and the signature Modest Mouse style cutouts that the series has become known for, the blend of styles really draws you in instead of pushing you away. Seeing the various artists' rendition of the same scenario, or the way that they'll use a certain visual cue to really hammer in home a scene, is fantastic. The various backgrounds, environments, all feel wildly different from one another, and even though some textures or backgrounds could get a bit muddy or pixelated at times, the scope and originality of everything being presented to you more than made up for that. Danganronpa Another Episode is proof that the series still has a lot of room to grow, even away from the traditional visual novel style that it's become known for. Despite the repetitive nature of the gameplay or the sometimes unruly camera, the game really does work as a third-person shooter, mostly in part to its fantastically written narrative and unique visual style. The focus on rich and well-developed characters thrown into a terrible situation is compelling throughout, and even when the gameplay feels lacking, the story and visuals draw you back in and force you to push forward. If you're a fan of the series, then you'll be happy to know that this is worth your time and money. If you're not, while a working knowledge of the first game is key to enjoying the game at its fullest, if you love third-person shooters wrapped in a deep and thoughtfully written story, and you have a PlayStation Vita, then you might want to consider giving this one a go.
So what are your thoughts on the game? Have you had a chance to play it yet? Are you a fan of the series? Be sure to leave a comment below letting you know what you think, but as always, be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share this video with whoever you want. And until then, I'll see you next time!